And welcome back to another episode of The Credit Authority. Again, I am your host, Rhonda Kulch, and I am so glad that you have the opportunity to join us today. We are speaking with industry professionals that support our Long Island community, and we are speaking about their backstories and how they got to achieve the level of success that they have today. So again, in studio with us is a previous guest that I've had on before, Mr. Dennis McGrath. How are you?
How are you, Rhonda? Thanks for having me back.
Love when you come in, because not only do you have good energy, but for today's episode, you have a great backstory. You're like the most fashionable attorney I know. So let's just jump right into it.
I've done a lot.
We know that, you know, I know just from personal conversations and experiences with you that law is something that you're passionate about, but
Absolutely.
It was not your first career.
No, as a matter of fact, actually, I started as a bond trader. I hated the numbers. So I had a client who owned a fashion company at that time. He invited me to come in and learn the industry with him. And inside of 4 years, I started my own company. So I was doing ladies' fashions. I was designing for Victoria's Secret, BB, Cachet, Chico's. I was doing a bunch of that. And we ended up growing, actually, building factories out into Mexico and China. And did that for many years. And but you know what? Everybody has a second life, you know, after you do something for a while.
And sometimes it's just time for something new.
Absolutely.
Mixing it up, new changes. You know, every year I always tell people, you'll know if you made my list, mm-hmm. because you get on January 1 a congratulations, you're still my friend, right? Because there are times in our life that we need to make sacrifices, mm-hmm. you know, whether it be in business or even personally, in order for you to grow as a person.
Mm-hmm.
So let's talk about your move into the legal field, which is really where I know you from.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
How long you been practicing now?
I've only been practicing law for about 5 years now. When I sold my fashion business, actually, I came back to Long Island, didn't want to do the commute anymore, and I wanted to change things up. So I started a for-profit company that's owned by the not-for-profit Cerebral Palsy of Nassau.
Oh, okay.
And I don't know if you knew about that.
Did not know. Learned something new every time.
I still run that company for them. It's called Rehab Solutions. And 100% of the profits go back to the agency. And I was trying to give back. You know, I wanted, after so many years in business on my own, I wanted to take my expertise and build a business for them. And I did. And it's working for them now. It's creating profits for the agency. But at that time, I realized, my wife said to me, you know, what do you want to do when you grow up at that point? And I said, I always wanted to be a lawyer. So she said, go do it. Mm-hmm. And when you have the support of the family around you and you know what you want to do and you set a goal, and that's, I think, the most important thing, Ron, is setting a goal, and it's a goal that you can measure. Mm-hmm. And once you have that, you can get there. Anybody can get there if you put the time and effort in. It's all about setting a goal and knowing where you want to be. So I went to law school at night while supporting my family and running this company. And became an attorney, and now that's what I'm doing primarily. I love my life right now.
Now, of course, you know, it's great to say that when I'm out and I'm visiting in the business community, you and I spend a lot of time together, mm-hmm. you know, out of the studio, because you are an attorney that mm-hmm. obviously I rely on mm-hmm. to service my clients.
Mm-hmm.
Tell me, though, a little bit about some of the challenges that you've faced as just getting involved in, you know, starting this new career.
You know, in starting a new career, everything takes sacrifice. Everything takes, well, you have to have a passion for what you want, first of all. Mm-hmm. Because if you don't, if you're just chasing the money, mm-hmm. you'll fail. Because that's not a long-term plan. What you need to do is find out something you're passionate about, then set that goal as to how you're going to get there. And understand that some goals are going to take years, mm-hmm. same as law school did with me. While I was working, I sacrificed. I went to school at night. It was a lot of hours, a lot of weekends. But at the end of the day, once I had that degree, I understood that I wasn't going to be able to leave law school and go into my own firm. So I worked for somebody for a few years, mm-hmm. learned the craft a little bit, surrounded myself with good people like yourself, mm-hmm. and opened my own firm, and now it's a success. And so what we're doing at this point is looking at the next growth opportunity and seeing where to take this, because you can't stay stagnant with that either, just saying that, you know what, now I'm a lawyer and I own a firm, what do I do with it?
Well, thank you. Mm-hmm. Because I think what happens along the way is people will go, well, you're a lawyer. Mm-hmm. You know, just like I have clients that are professionals in other capacities, mm-hmm. and they don't identify with the fact mm-hmm. that just because you're an attorney doesn't mean that you're not an entrepreneur and a business owner.
You need to be, and that's a big part of the big difference between working for a firm and owning a firm. When you work for a firm, it's a job. You get your paycheck, you show up each day, you do the hours that you need to do, and depending on the work you do, you get bonuses. Mm-hmm. When you own your firm, you have to market, you have to do SEO, meaning internet advertising, yeah. you have to go to networking events, you have to talk to people, and you have to actually have a plan. A plan as to where you want to get. And when you do that, you take some chances in growth. I'm hiring additional attorneys this year. We're getting additional office space because we see opportunities in the market that are coming up. And I understand there's risks on that, and risks are scary. Mm-hmm. Risks are scary because you work hard for that money that you have there. So you don't want to throw 100%. It away.
Yeah.
But on the flip side, you don't want to not risk it and stay stagnant. Otherwise, you'll remain a mom and pop shop.
Now, we know we talk about your legal business. Let's actually identify for the people that are listening and the people that are watching, what kind of law do you practice?
We do a lot of real estate and personal injury. By real estate, we do, of course, home sales, home purchases, short sales, but another very large part of my practice is foreclosure defense. Mm-hmm. And people who are in trouble with their mortgages, there's options for them. It's not always, you know, the banks have their lawyers.
Yeah.
And a lot of people don't think that if they put their head in the sand, you know what, eventually the problem will resolve itself, and it won't. You need an attorney who's going to come in there and defend you on that. And there's goals. I mean, everybody, that's, again, the same as with a business. Consider it a business transaction. Your business transaction was you entered into a contract on a mortgage, and the contract says you have to pay it back. Well, you know what, treat it as a business at this point. If you're in default, what do you do with it? Mm-hmm. And there's options for us that we present. And with your help,
yeah, of course.
We help them with their credit. We help them in getting modifications on that loan if that's viable. If it's not, we keep them in that home as long as possible. And then we create a plan, an exit plan, that they can leave on their terms rather than being kicked out by a sheriff showing up one day. At this point, perhaps we give them some money as moving money, or we negotiate it. And we leave them in a better place than when they came to us.
But you want to make sure that they're not responding as a victim.
Exactly.
And I think that, even for mm-hmm. my clients, is always the mm-hmm. most important thing, is the fact that when they're working with myself, or they're working with you, or, you know, other professionals mm-hmm. within our capacity, mm-hmm. that everybody's make sure that, you know, our clients do not leave feeling like a victim.
And that's actually a good lesson for life. I mm-hmm. mean, it's you should always be out in front of the problem. Mm-hmm. If you're not, you know, you're reacting to yeah. the outside forces. Instead, take control of it.
100%. A lot has to be mm-hmm. said for somebody that really is in a position to mm-hmm. help guide somebody mm-hmm. and create success for them. So now, what is your next journey? Like, what could we expect coming up from, you know, from Dennis?
I wanted to go to medical school, but my wife nixed that one, so.
No, I kind of still need you in the legal space right now.
Yeah,
so, I have no time for you to go to medical school.
So we're growing at that point, as I said. We're taking larger office space, hiring other attorneys, and with the foreclosure moratorium in New York coming to an end, uh-huh. it's on January 15th, it's coming to an end. So a lot of people are going to have to face the music on
yeah.
that, and it's going to create an opportunity in the legal field, and it's an opportunity for us to help more people.
It's
not just a business opportunity, but it's an opportunity to help, and I want to give back again the same way that I did with the cerebral palsy of Nassau. You know, it's not always about taking. You know, yes, do I get paid for my services? Of course I do, but it's not. It's about a bigger
Bigger picture.
Bigger picture than that, absolutely.
I love it, I love it. Well, we are with Dennis McGrath. He is an attorney at law. If you or somebody you know may be facing foreclosure, or you have not made appropriate steps to resolving your moratorium, as you might be a homeowner that's still facing some financial struggles, please consider reaching out to our guest, Dennis McGrath. I'm sure him and his staff would be more than happy to accommodate a consultation and give you an action plan on how you can get in front of your situation. Stay tuned for our next guest.